Yes, Vipul Singh, we are live, guys. Am I audible to you? Am I audible to you guys? Yes. Let's crack IIT
Am I audible
JEE in
to you
English.
guys?
With us here at Unacademy, where you have top educators, quality content. Hola, Yogeshwar Paida. Hi, Vipul Singh. How are you guys? Hello, Sim24. So let's crack IIT JEE in English, guys. It's here at Unacademy. This is JEE in English. It's an English program. Most of the program channels have been in Hindi. So this is a new venture by Unacademy. So let's get starting. What a game, man, by the way. You saw the match today. KL Rahul really killed it, no? Very nice ball, batting. Okay, guys, so let's crack IIT JEE here at Unacademy. Before we go further, I want you all to stay home, maintain social distancing, and wash your hands regularly. Okay, so stay safe at home. Don't roam outside. Very horrible outside. Yes, KL Baba in full form. Yes. Okay, so hi guys, I am N. Nagashiv Srikanth. I did my BTech from IIT Kharagpur with an AIR of 3.5. I've been guiding students like you guys, guiding more than teaching for the last 5 years. Why I call myself a guide is because, you know, I discuss about everything, not just studies. And I believe in students' nature. It's not like if you are very strict on yourself, it becomes very hard. So I'm not like normal teaching. So I like to call myself a guide. Okay, I'm a Sunrisers fan. Let's see day after tomorrow. And DC is equally marvelous, if not better. I'm a DC fan. So if you have anything to say, hit the comment section. Before we go further, hit the like, subscribe, share, and send it everywhere, okay? Because I want this to reach everyone. This is cracking IIT JEE, India's largest platform, which is Unacademy. Get the plus subscription to access unlimited live and recorded courses for India's best educators. So get the subscription with my code NSS1. So this is the program I'm launching. That is why it's a unique thing. It is JEE Advanced Solutions. Okay, it's a fortnight program for 15 days. I'm covering all every year's question paper. Every year's question paper, we are reaching the end of it. So this is fortnight advanced solutions. So today I'm going to discuss 2018 paper one. So as I told you, the last 2 years I'll cover all the papers. So we have 4 days left and I'll be teaching 2018 and 19 all papers. That is why I condensed all the previous papers into single paper, because now we can do all the problems. Okay, so let's start off. The first question: the potential energy of a particle of mass m at a distance r from a fixed point O is given by Vr is equal to kr square by 2. It is kr square by 2. Okay. Where k is a positive constant. Now, what does this remind you of? This will remind you of a spring force. This is a spring force. So this is what I wanted you to understand. Where k is a positive constant of appropriate dimensions, this particle is moving in a circular orbit of radius r about a point O. If the speed of the particle is v and L is the magnitude of angular momentum about O, which of the following statements is true? Now, how does this spring work? The first thing you have to understand is, how does this spring work? So there is a radius of r, he's saying, right? So it's radius of r. Okay, where r is the distance from the fixed point O. The fixed point, so say whatever expansion is there, that is only the force. So the force back will be kr. And how will the particle move? The particle will move in a circular motion like this. It is undergoing circular motion like this. Getting it? So this is how it will undergo circular motion. So, and he's giving us that the what are the values which are given? He's giving us the speed v. He's giving us the speed v. He gave us the value of r. And he gave the value of mass. Mass is m. Okay, these are the three values which are given to us. We have to solve for velocity and for angular momentum. Okay. Directly, he's only given us the magnitude, so we'll just find the magnitudes. So if you draw the free body diagram, let's draw the free body diagram for this. What is the force acting on the particle? There is only single force, right? There is no other force acting. If you see carefully, there is only a single force acting, which is equal to K into R, right? This is the force. And as a result of it, what is the acceleration in the x direction we are taking at this instant? It is undergoing circle like this with the center at this point, right? Center of circle. So from this we can say acceleration will be equal to v square by r, right? We can say acceleration is v square by r towards O. The acceleration is towards O. From this directly we can interpret what? That fx is equal to m into A, right? F into fx is equal to m into A. What is the fx here? Kr. So kr will be equal to m into acceleration, which is v square by r. It's very simple. The centripetal acceleration will be equal to spring force. That is all it is. So if you observe carefully, when it is rotating, normally if you have a thread, you will have tension there. No, tension will be mv square by r. But in this case, it's a spring. So spring force will be equal to mv square by r. It's straightforward. From this directly, what will you get? V square is equal to kr square by m, or v is equal to root km by r, km into r. Which of the following options? Root km by r, root km into r, which is option B. This is option B. Simple. Now let's solve for the next part. What is angular momentum? What is angular momentum, guys? You can write the formula in letters directly. I'm waiting for you. What is the formula for angular momentum? Come on, guys, quickly. Yes, very good, Sim24. You got it right. Angular momentum is mvr. What is I omega? Yogeshwar Paida, what is I? Where is I here? We can directly write in terms of mvr, no? There is no I and omega there. I omega is also correct, but that is only for rotating bodies. Got it? Here it is mvr, perfect. Because we know v, we know m, we know r, we can directly find out this value. So, I will write the magnitude. Actually, in vector form, it will be m into p cross r. This way, you have to remember, it's p cross, it is r cross p, no? Which is m into r cross v. So, in formula, in vector form, this is the correct answer. Otherwise, you can write L as mvr, okay? It's I omega is not useful here. Substitute values, m into r into root k by m into r. Directly, what am I getting? Root mk into r square. Got it. So, this is the solution. Which of the following options is that? Oh, we got the answer C. So, options are B and C. Okay, got it. Good job. Sim24, Yogeshwar Paida, you got it right. But you have to use it in the right way. Okay. The correct formula here will be mvr. Cool. Next question. Consider a body of mass 1 kg at rest at the origin at time t is equal to 0. Force is alpha ti cap plus beta j cap. The mass is 1 kg. So, this is one simple simplicity we can use. Because force will be equal to acceleration. Simple, no? This funda you have to use here. Because it will become easy to calculate. Alpha is 1, beta is 1. Everything is 1, man. The torque acting on the body at t is equal to 1 second is tau. This is a little lengthy. Which of the following is or true? Let's find out. So, what do we know? Acceleration only is equal to force. Is equal to alpha t I cap plus beta j cap. So alpha is 1, beta is 1. So what will I do? I will directly write it as ti cap plus j cap. This is acceleration. Getting it? So what will velocity be? It is integration of a dt, right? It is integration of a dt. From this directly, t dt is how much? T square by 2. That is t square by 2 I cap plus t j cap. Integration of 1 is t. So we can directly write this. And similarly, displacement I will write it as t square by 2 integration is how much? Take 1 by 2 outside. T square integration is t cube by 3. Integration of t square is t cube by 3. So, I will directly do 1 by 2 into t cube by 3 because it is product. So, I will directly get t cube by 6 I cap plus t square by 2 j cap. How? Because t I cap integration is already t square by 2. No, we did the I cap here in these both. Same logic I will apply for this t. We will get this. So, at 1 second. Now, we got the values. I will substitute them at 1 second. At t is equal to 1 second. What is the force and acceleration equal to? I cap plus j cap. No, it's simple. T is 1. We'll directly substitute. Velocity vector will be how much? T square by 2. What is the value of t square by 2? At t is equal to 1, directly 1 by 2. 1 by 2 I cap plus j cap. And what is the displacement vector? 1 by 6. That is substitute t cube. 1 cube is 1. So you get 1 by 6 I cap plus 1 by 2 So these are the three values we found out. So directly we can check the values. Velocity of the body at t is equal to 1 second. What was it? I by 2 plus j. If you check, is that correct? I by 2 plus j, no, that is what is given. So option C is correct. From this directly option C, we'll get the value. Okay. So magnitude of displacement of the body at t is equal to 1 second is 1 by 6 meters. If you substitute magnitude of displacement at 1 second, how much is it? Root 1 by 6 square plus 1 by 2 square. No, root x square plus y square is magnitude of displacement. Is it correct? Because 1 by 6 is already there. Extra 1 by 2 is also there. So it is not possible. Now we have to find the torque. Torque is how much? It is R cross F. Yes, do you know this? No, Yogeshwar, you know this, right? Torque is R cross F. Okay, now we'll directly substitute the values. 1 by 6 I cap plus 1 by 2 J cap cross I cap plus J cap. Because the force is equal to acceleration is equal to I cap plus J cap. No, T is equal to 1. So directly what will this value be? I cross J is K. So 1 by 6 K cap. And J cross I is minus 1 by 2. Yes, Adarsh Varala. Hi, Adarsh. 1 by J cross I is minus K. So directly we'll write minus 1 plus 1 by 2 into minus K. So if you add both of them, we'll get 1 by 6 minus 1 by 2, which is minus 1 by 3 K cap. So this is the torque. So which of the following, the direction of torque is in plus K direction. Is it correct? No, it is not, because it is minus K direction. And magnitude of torque is 1 by 3, which is exactly correct. So option A and C are correct. Getting it? So this kind of solutions I will be giving you slowly as time passes. I don't have the PDF ready yet, but we'll be doing these kind of solutions. Just to give you a hint of where we're going. Okay. Capillary tube of inner radius R is dipped vertically into a beaker filled with water. The water rises to a height H. It's a standard capillary tube question. Above the water surface in a beaker. The surface tension of water is rho. Surface tension is given as rho. And the angle of contact between the water and the capillary walls is theta. Ignore the mass of water in the meniscus. Okay, we are assuming that is not there. So we will not get that cos theta's formula and all there. Simpler question. Which of the following statements is true? So how will it be? This is the diagram. This is how it will be. This angle is theta. This angle is theta. This will be theta. And this height is h. And this radius is r. So what do we know about height here? It's a very simple formula. You have to remember this. H is equal to 2t cos theta by r rho g. Where r is t is tension, rho is density, g is gravity, r is radius, surface tension, radius, this is density, and this is acceleration due to gravity. Acceleration due to gravity basically. Or it is basically the force downwards. It is basically the force downwards. Acceleration downwards in case of free fall. Let's leave that for now. So we'll solve this question. So from this, what is given? Or we can also write in this case as is equal to 2 sigma cos theta by R. Okay. Now for a given material, H decreases with increase in R. What can we say from here? H is inversely proportional to R, right? H is proportional to 1 by R. Right. Which means it will decrease with increase in right. So from this directly we can say it is correct. And next, H is independent of sigma. We are getting H is proportional to sigma, no, from here. H is proportional to sigma. So from this, it is not independent. So option 2 is wrong. If experiment is performed in a lift going up with constant acceleration, then H decreases. What I want you to understand is this G here is acceleration due to gravity in the frame of reference. Okay. So normally, in normal case, if you leave water, it will fall down with acceleration g. So we got g in the denominator. If it is falling in a lift, you know there will be a pseudo force downward, right? Extra force. As a result, surface tension which is acting upward, if you, let's draw this diagram, I'll explain it again. There is surface tension force upwards which is equal to 2t cos theta. And then there will be m into g, right? If the lift is going up, you'll have to add an extra pseudo force. Getting it? So then in this case, the total tension 2t cos theta will be equal to m into g plus a. So the height will become g plus a instead of g. You're getting the point? Draw free body diagram, you'll understand there will be an extra force downward when it's accelerating up. Because of that, the height will reduce. Because surface tension will give only same force, 2t cos theta, 2 pi rt cos theta. It is 2 pi rt cos theta. It will give the same force in either cases. But if it's going up, the height will reduce. If it is coming down, there will be pseudo force upward. So 2t cos theta plus ma will be mg. So then the height will increase. If it is falling down, the height will increase. If it is going up, the height will decrease. Just like the feeling you get inside. If it is going down, you feel like you're floating up. No, the same feeling even water will experience inside. Getting it? So h is proportional to the contact angle, and it is proportional to cos theta. If you observe, h is proportional to what? It is proportional to cos theta. So it is not related with theta. It is related with cos theta. It is proportional to that. So this is the explanation. From this we can say the answer is AC. Got it, others? Yeah, you've been doing very good. I'm very happy with the response you've been giving. Nice to see you guys. Okay, now let's go to the next question. Hi, Pradeep Chowdhury. Welcome. So in the figure below, the switches S1 and S2 are simultaneously closed simultaneously. Thank you guys, it's very nice. Like at this time I'm surprised that you guys are giving that much attention, which is very cool. You will go a long way. Just focus on the techniques. If at all I find any question, if I find any technique, I'm telling it right away. So just listen to it. If not, see it. You can listen to it and solve problems also. So keep listening and keep sharing it everywhere. Let's go to this night duty. Exactly, it's very nice. I like staying in the night. I'm a night person. Basically, I play music, so I enjoy staying in the night time. It is very, it's a time I feel very active. You know, musicians work at night, so I like to work at night either too. Okay. Two switches S1 S2 are closed simultaneously. So it's just that this will become like this and this will become like this. Now, before that, there was no current, no? The moment both the switches are closed, there will be current flowing like this because of this. And there will be current flowing like this because of this. Let's call this current I1, let's call this current I2. Okay, there will be two currents. One is I1 in clockwise here and I2 based on this voltage only I drew. Okay, so he is telling us polarities are indicated as given below. Ignore mutual inductance, which is a big relief. I don't want to involve you. Simply write two equations, we can get the answer. No need to find mutual. The current I in the middle of the wire reaches I max at time t is equal to tau. The time when the current reaches maximum. So which of the following statements are true? This is a lengthy question. So I will write the equations, then we can solve it. So what is the equations here? So this is one circuit, and this is one circuit. We'll draw it, we'll get it in no time, man. Pradeep, this is R and L, R and 2L. This is the only thing which is given. Circuit 1. And this is circuit 2. So what can we say about I? What is the direction given? It is given as downward, no? So from this I can say I will be equal to I1 is adding to it and I2 is subtracting to it. No, if you check this swipe, this is coming down like this and this is going up like this. So it will be I1 minus I2. That's the basic simple first step to this. I didn't get your point, man. Okay, it's a little tough to interact with this on live chat, okay. Okay, let's do it. I'm doing it, man. I'm doing it for you. Don't worry. Okay, so what is the I? Generally, when in an LR circuit, what is the value of I? You know, LR circuit, what does an inductor do? It stops immediate flow of current, but it will slowly allow current to flow in, right? So directly from that, there are two formulas we can put. One is e power minus t by rc formula will be there. Another will be 1 minus e power t, that equation. Okay. So there are only. Okay. Chalo, theek hai. Keep having fun. But don't spam yaar. Matlab, I'm reading the chat also. So let me tell you. There will be generally two types of formulas. No, I naught into e power minus t by rc you will get minus t by tau, or you will get one more thing, I naught into 1 minus e power minus t by tau. This kind of, there are only two formulas you will get. So inductor, directly it will start off with zero current, no? So directly by logic I can write I1 will be equal to V by R, which is the actual current flow, into 1 minus e power R T by L. Getting it? This is the formula for the current flowing. Getting it? So, and I2 will be how much? Because this is inductor, initial current will be 0. Just put T is 0 and get value 0. So, from that directly we can get it will be 1 minus e power. Okay. So, V by R into 1 minus e power minus RT by 2L. Because the inductor here is 2L. Understood? So, directly from this I will get I will be equal to V by R into 1 minus e power and 1 minus e power. No, it will be I1 minus I2. So, the negative part may, negative of negative will become positive. Directly I'll write here V by R into V by R minus V by R into e power minus R T by L minus V by R plus V by R into e power minus R T by 2L. If you observe carefully, because this is minus, no, this is I1 and this is minus of I2, no, minus, so I'm making this minus I2. You're getting my point? So this is I1, this is minus I2. Getting it? So from this directly, this V by R and V by R are getting cancelled. So what are we remaining with? V by R into V minus e power RT by 2L plus RT by 2L minus RT by L. So this is the formula for I. Okay. So this is the formula for I. So he's asking us at the time when this is maximum and what is the value of the maximum. Okay. So how do we do that? We have to differentiate. No, this I differentiation should be 0 is the condition for maxima. Because eventually it will become 0. Getting it? At 1 it is 0. At eventually when time is very high, it will also become 0. Because both the cases, both the values will be equal. But in the middle, it will grow and then fall down. We have to find the maximum value of that. It will be this graph will be like this if you observe. I will also teach you some graphs along the way if it is possible. It will be like this. It will grow up and then gradually fall down. This is generally how the function works. Yes. So, okay, maximum value. Array, it's okay, man. Feel free to give answers, okay? I want you guys, all of you, to keep giving answers, okay? Feel free to participate. Though it might be a little delayed, I'm free to answer. I'm happy to answer. Yes. So, maxima is, we have to differentiate this. Now, what is the differentiation of e power minus e power kt? Differentiation will be equal to k into e power kt, right? E power kt by dt will be k e power kt. So that only I'll apply here. Okay. I'll apply here. What will I get? Minus V by R into minus. So I'll take V by R common anyway. Di by dt. Well, let me write it here. Di by dt is equal to E by R common lele. Then minus T by 2 minus R by 2L. That is the only proper. What is the K in the first case? It is minus R by 2L. So I directly will write it outside. Minus R by 2L into minus R T by 2L minus minus of minus R by L. Getting it? Here, because the constant in the second case is minus R by L into e power minus R T by L is equal to 0. This is the equation. It might look a little lengthy, but once you solve it, it becomes very, very good. Okay. So, directly R by L into, one thing if you observe, this one whole square, if you call it alpha, this is alpha square, right? This is the simplest way, okay? The moment you see this much big calculation, I know a lot of you will get irritated, okay? So what will I tell you? This is a very nice trick. If this you take it as some alpha, this will be, because this whole thing, a power m whole power, e power m whole power n is e power mn. So e power minus rt by 2l into 2 is e power minus rt by l, no? So directly I'll write this as alpha square. This way I can make the question easy in no time. Ek simple sa ho gaya, it's over from there. Minus R by 2L into alpha plus alpha square into R by L is equal to 0. From this directly I'll get alpha is equal to how much? Check it, no? Alpha square into R by L is equal to alpha into R by 2L. So R, LL are gone. Alpha and 1 alpha is gone. Alpha is equal to 1 by 2. So directly from this I can get the value e power minus RT by 2L is equal to 1 by 2. So what is it? Minus RT by 2L is equal to LN 1 by 2. So from time will be 2L by R into ln 2. This is only the value of the time, which is equal to 2L by R into ln 2, which is option D. This is option D. Getting it? Now we have to substitute in this whole thing. It might look a little big, but I'll tell you one thing. E power minus RT by 2L is 1 by 2. And how much? This is 1 by 2. And how much will this be? This is only alpha, no? So directly I'll substitute it here. I is equal to V by R into e power minus RT by 2L is alpha. Alpha minus alpha square is the option, which is V by R into 1 by 2 minus 1 by 4, which is V by 4R. Getting the point? So if you take, simplify it in a very small way, just e power minus RT by, it's looking very big, no? Think of it, it's looking very big. So what I'll do is I'll make it as alpha. The moment you do that, this trick, that is a trick, everything is done. Understood? So this is the kind of method I want you guys to apply in the exam. Don't just keep sticking with a big equations. Every big equation you can always simplify into small equations, and I want you guys to do exactly that. Okay, simplify big equations into small equations. Now I want to write this somewhere. So options are BD. This is the solution for it. Okay, so yeah. I want to simplify this into small equations. Okay, I'll write this in the meantime. Okay, two infinitely long wires lie in xy plane along the lines x is equal to plus or minus r. So there are two lines, one in the forward direction, one in the backward direction. No, there are two wires, one at plus r and one at minus r. One in the positive x direction and one in the negative. Both wires are located at x is equal to plus r. X is equal to plus r carries a current I1 and x is equal to minus r carries I2. So I drew the diagrams here. X is equal to plus R carries I1. Okay. Just this. This is I2. Let me just change it a little. This is I2 and this is I1. Okay. X is equal to plus R, it is I2, and this is equal to 6 minus R, it is I2. The circular loop of radius R is suspended with the center at 0, 0, root 3. It is somewhere at the top. It is suspended at 0, 0, root 3R in a plane parallel to the xy plane. It is just like this. The xy plane, this is. The loop carries current I in the clockwise direction as seen from the up the loop. From above, if you see, it is moving in clockwise, which means the current is moving in this direction. Getting the point? So from above, it is moving in clockwise. If you see carefully from above, it is moving like this. Means that is how the current is. Getting it? Okay. This loop carries a constant current I in the clockwise direction as seen from above the loop. The current in the wire is taken to be positive if it is in the J direction. Which of the following options are magnetic field at true? If I1 is equal to I2, then B cannot be 0 at the origin. So one thing we know, if I1 and I2 are same, what is the force due to magnetic field? Force due to magnetic, the magnetic field due to current carrying wire. The magnetic field due to a current carrying wire will be I into L cross B. So wait. I DL cross R. No, I into DL cross R. I into DL cross R. This is how it is, no? You know what, it by 4 pi, this is also there. So this is how it is. So I won't be discussing the full formula also. I'll only take DL cross R. That is the direction of magnetic field due to a current carrying wire. Okay. So now current carrying wire is in positive J direction, means it is coming out like this. What do I show you? It is coming out like this, no? Yeah, this is the correct way. So it is coming inside like this. DL cross R, you have to take the direction of current cross R. Okay, so the direction of length here is it is going this way, so current will be in this direction. So DL is the direction will be in this direction, cross R. What is the direction of field? It will be upward. And same way, if I1 is going in this direction, it will be downward, and I2 will cause the field upward. So field due to I1 will be in the DL cross R downward side. It will be minus k cap. And B due to I2 will be in K cap direction. Directions. Getting it? These are the two directions we need to take care of. What are the two directions? The direction of I1 is downward. DL cross R. and direction of I2 is upward, getting it dl cross r. So these are the two directions we'll get. Okay, so from this we'll find out if I1 is greater than 0 and I2 is greater than 0, B1 can be equal to 0 at the origin. Okay, first if I1 and I2 are equal, from this what can we say? That the net field due to both the wires will become 0, because both will be in opposite directions, they'll cancel out. And what is the field? There is an extra field due to the current carrying loop. So that way the field at the origin cannot be equal to 0. So option A is wrong. It cannot be equal to 0. If I1 is greater than 0 and I2 is less than 0, then the field can be equal to 0 at the origin, he's saying. So if I1 is greater than 0, the direction of current is downwards, and I2 is greater than 0, direction of field will be downwards, and direction of field due to the current carrying loop will be upward, getting it? Due to I1, due to I2 will be 0, but the loop will be upward, is carrying current this way, getting it? The loop is carrying current this way, the direction due to loop will be upward, but direction due to current loops will become positive. So both of these are downwards. Field due to I1 and I2 downwards, but field due to I is upwards. As a result, the sum can be 0. Which means option B is also correct. Okay. And first case we understood that the field due to I1 and I2 cannot be equal to 0 at the origin if I1 is equal to I2 is also true. Basically, it cannot be 0, no, because of the loop. So this is also correct and this is also correct. If I1 is less than 0, I2 is greater than 0, B can be equal to 0 at the origin. Now just the opposite. Now both of these together will give a same direction as the current in the loop. Getting it? So as a result, the total cannot be equal to 0. This cannot be possible, because due to I1 and I2 it will have same direction, and due to field also it will have same direction. Getting it? So now if I1 is equal to I2, the Z component of the magnetic field at the center of the loop will be the Z component at the center of loop. What is the formula for this? It is equal to mu naught I by 2R, no? Which is only what is given in the option. Getting it? Z component is mu naught I by 2R, which is only given in the option. So option D is also correct. So from this we can say that the options are ABD. Getting it? So this is a theoretical question. It's not a problem solving question. So let's go to the next question. This is also looking like a theoretical one. So that is one advantage with multiple choice. Okay, if you have this is all a little more theoretical involved. So it will not take as much time as solving a problem, but you have to use the right techniques. Like in this question also, let's see. 1 mole of monoatomic gas undergoes a cyclic process as shown in the figure. It's undergoing a cyclic process. Cool. Which of the following statements is true? Process 1 is isochoric. What is isochoric means? Isochoric means the volume will not change. So in this case, volume is changing, right? Clearly you can see. So first option is wrong. It's not an isochoric. Process 2 absorbs heat. Process 2, what is heat? Basically, heat will be delta U plus W. That's all, no? So in this case, yes, correct. So in process 2, gas absorbs heat. In process 2, the temperature is increasing. The temperature is fixed. Isothermal. But volume is increasing, which means that time work done will be nRT ln V2 by V1. Or V final by V initial. So V final is greater than V initial, which means work done will be positive. And what is change in internal energy? It is 0, because it's isothermal process. So from this directly we can say delta Q will be positive, because delta U is 0 and work done is positive. So directly it will absorb heat. So what is delta Q great positive means? It means that the total entropy of the substance is increasing, like the body state is increasing. It is going to higher state, which means somebody should give it energy, or in short we can say it is taking energy from. Like Hulk in the movie. In the Hulk movie, he'll take energy from everywhere and he'll become, he'll start becoming more and more powerful. Like in the first Hulk movie. Like that one. He'll take energy and it'll go to a higher state. Okay. Just like Black Panther, basically. Black Panther will absorb the energy and he'll go into more energy state. No, same thing happens. He'll absorb heat. In this case, it's heat. And in process 4, gas releases heat. In process 4, what is happening? Process 4 is also isothermal, just that in process 4, the volume final is less than volume initial, which means work done is negative. Delta U is 0, which means delta Q will be negative. Hence, we can say it is releasing heat. So even option C is correct. Option processes 1 and 3 are not isobaric. 1 and 3 are isobaric. How does isobaric look in a VT graph? In VT graph, in T by V graph basically. What do we know? If pressure is constant, we can say V is proportional to T, no, directly. So V is proportional to T means it should be graphs which are passing through the origin. Got this, right? If V is proportional to T, it means it is passing through the origin. So none of the processes here are passing through the origin. So none of them are isobaric. So directly we'll get the answer as are not isobaric. Man, this is not isobaric only. It is not isobaric. That is what we got. Pressure is not constant. Which is only correct. Of course, getting it. So be careful. You have to read the solution carefully. Read the answer. 1 and 3 are not isobaric is what is given. Not is also mentioned in star. See, this kind of mistakes, I want you guys to see what I am doing right now and don't do it in the exam. Okay, that is what I want you guys to do. Understand that it is not isobaric. You have to not forget reading that. This kind of points are very important. Especially there will be some points where they'll be asking the question in temperature, you'll get the answer in Kelvin. Or you'll get the answer in centigrade, they'll be asking in Kelvin. You'll make a mistake in those kind of things. So read the answer carefully. This is what I want you to understand. Understood? So option D is not isobaric and pressure is not constant, which is correct. Clear? Okay. Next. Two vectors, A vector is AI cap and B vector is A cos omega T I cap plus. So by the way, this is the end of first section. Great job, guys. So we are done with the more than one option questions. Now for integer values. Okay, there's a little issue. I put the previous slide in the previous one. But good job, guys. So before we go further, I'll just talk about Unacademy. Unacademy is India's largest learning platform. Okay, crack IITJ with India's largest learning platform, which is Unacademy. Get the plus subscription to access unlimited live and recorded courses from India's best educators, not only just one educator from a particular place, unlike traditional structure. We'll have it from across the country. We are basically nationalizing the educational system. Okay, so what you will get with the Unacademy app is you'll get daily live classes where you can chat and engage in discussion and ask your doubts, everything, all while the class is going on. That is the main thing I was talking about. You'll have dynamic discussion in the app. Okay, everything will happen in the class. You can, any answer which you want to tell, you can press the quiz. You can press the poll button. You can ask your doubts directly. I can see it there in front of me. So I'll tell you, we are going to have it from Saturday. The first class will be on Saturday. So even I'll be launching live class inside the app. So go for it. Okay. There'll be structured course, unlike here. It will be all structured in line with the exam syllabus. Okay. Exam syllabus will be properly divided among the entire thing. And you'll have live quizzes and tests. I keep telling everyone around that every student I meet that you have to write quizzes every day. Every day you have to write a quiz. Only then you will have in practice of writing exams. Not only physics, chemistry, maths. If you do that every day, that will not be enough. You have to do quizzes also every day. You have to practice for the exam. And you can get a lot of quizzes and tests in the app. And you'll have unlimited access to, you'll get all your live and recorded sessions. You will not just have live sessions, you also have recorded sessions to watch for your comfort. Okay, from any teacher from across the country. Like one teacher who's teaching organic well in Kota will also be there, and someone from South India who teaches maths well will also be there. I will also be there. So it will be fun. Install the learning app right away. It's a very nice under subscription. If I come to subscription, the main thing why if you observe, I've just focused on this. Why? Matlab, this is 7,000 per month, for 1 month. Okay. But this is 38,500 for 12 months. What is the main advantage of this is, there are other offers here, but I'll go stress here. This is especially for 2021 guys and for the those who are taking dropper, those who are dropping this year because of the situation right now, those who have lost team and want to take one extra year, it's a very good idea right now, especially in this situation. You will be in a very good situation, especially those who are dropping. Let me tell you why. Because you have already been preparing till now. You are in this flow. If you give it only 6 more months, you'll have the exam again. 4 more months basically. That is why I want dropping is also not the, such a bad idea. Okay, 4 months you can just steam through by proper planning, which I'll tell you in the next class, in the special classes. Okay, so this is 38,500. Now, why I'm stressing on this is, if 7,000 is for 1 month, by unitary method, 12 months will be 84,000. But this is like less than 50% of it. Not only that, if you use my code NSS1, NSS1 is the code you need to use. You use this code and you will get an additional 10% off, which means this 38,500 will now become 0.9 into 38,500. What is the value of that? It is 34,650. Okay. So this, let me tell you the significance of this figure. This might look big on the year perspective, but you'll have EMIs also. And 2,888 is the value per month. Now, let me tell you, if I divide this into PCM, it will come out to be 996 rupees per month. 1000 rupees, it is less than 1000 rupees per month for physics, chemistry and maths, which is 33 rupees per day. 33 rupees per day, matlab, what is this, man? This, that is why I'm actually happy to explain this to you, because it is actually a very nice deal despite of looking big right now. It's a pretty cool deal if you ask me. 33 rupees per day, I like the number there. So use this code NSS1 and just take it. Okay, so now let's get back to the previous question. This is a numerical value question. Let's solve this. Okay, this is a numerical value type questions from now. From now, you have to write the answers. This is numerical value. So from this, from the given paper, you have to write the value. Okay, you have to write the value. Getting it? So everywhere I'm just giving 0.0 here, because decimal places, so you have to show some decimal place to give the accuracy. You can't just write 2 as the answer. It's not an integer type question. It's a numerical value question. Okay. Two vectors A and B are defined by A I cap and B A cos omega t plus sin omega t J cap. Where A is a constant and omega is pi by 6 radians. It is pi by 6 radians. Got it. So this is moving in circular motion type. This is only moving. This is only in A direction. If A plus B vector is equal to root 3 times A minus B vector, the time t is equal to tau for the first time. Value of tau in seconds is. So this is the first time this situation is happening. Before this, this situation never happened. Now you know how to find the magnitude of two vectors, right? Wow, man, very good. Perfect. That's very good, Yogeshwar. Good job. 2 is the right answer. Let's solve it. Okay. What is mod of A vector plus B vector? Now one thing we know is this vector is like this, A vector, and B vector will be like this. Okay, this angle is only omega t. Getting it? This vector is, this angle is only omega t. And we know that both of them will have same magnitude. Something like this. Both of them have a magnitude of A. So, one thing, this is a simple method to solve it. Okay, I'll tell that simpler method now, because Yogeshwar already gave the answer. This is going to be really cool. This is A vector like this. And B vector is like this. Okay, what do we know? That A vector plus B vector is root 3 times A vector minus B vector. Now we know one thing, if the angle is theta, I keep telling you this formula, you can remember that sum of two vectors will be, the magnitude will be equal to 2a cos theta by 2. Getting it? And the minimum, then so difference between the vectors will be obviously the ulta, 2a sin theta by 2. So this is what I can say. This is one trick we can use, or I'll explain the solution in the again. But this is a very nice method we can use. So directly from this we can write off, divide both of them, we'll get is equal to root 3. So from this directly I'll get tan theta by 2 is equal to 1 by root 3, or theta by 2 is equal to 30 degrees, or theta is equal to 60 degrees, that is pi by 3. The first solution is pi by 3. From there you will have multiple solutions. So for the first solution, this only I can write it as omega t. So pi by 3 is equal to omega, which is equal to pi by 6 into t. From this I will get t is equal to 2 seconds. Good job, Yogeshwar. Very nice. Got this point. It's a simple trick this way. There is another way of solving it, which I will do it again in the alternate method. This is a little lengthy, but this is foolproof. If you don't remember this formula, I'll do it. Okay. What is the magnitude of two vectors? It is a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta. No. So directly I'll write it as a square plus 2a square into cos theta. Will be equal to root 3. This under root of this is magnitude. I'm squaring this. I'm squaring. So directly I'll get this is equal to 3 times a square plus a square minus 2a square cos theta. This way also we can solve. So directly 2a square common if we take 1 plus cos theta is equal to 3 into 1 minus cos theta. 2a square. Cancel both of them. 1 plus cos theta is equal to 3 minus 3 cos theta. From this we can get, how much we will get? 4 cos theta is equal to 2. Cos theta is equal to 1 by 2. And the first solution of theta is pi by 3. Again, we'll apply the same way, we'll get the answer. Got it? So, now for the next question. Okay. Two men are walking. The next question is, two men are walking along horizontal straight line in the same direction. In the same direction. The man in front walks with a speed of 1 and the man behind is walking with a speed of 2. Let's just draw a line here. Man is walking with 1. And here is walking with 2. Now both of them, the third man is standing at a height 12 meters above the same horizontal line. So since he's telling above, I'll draw it a little below here. You can draw it ulta also, actually it doesn't matter. 1 meter per second. This is meters per second. Okay, a man is standing at 12 meters from this. Now I want you to understand, if I draw flip this diagram also, will the answer change? He is telling this whole thing. Two men are walking identical whistles of sound 1430 hertz. 1430 hertz in both sides. Okay. The speed of air is 330 meters per second. Getting it? And this is one more thing. Why did he give 330 here and 1430 here? Again, I will tell you one wonderful logic. This 1430 I can write it as 13 into 11, 13 11s are 143. Know this method, no? After 11, all 11 table, 11 11s are 121, 11 12s are 132, 11 13s are 143, 11 14s are 154. This way we'll get 11 into 110. This is the trick. This is the method you have to, this is the main thing you have to understand from the values. Like I told yesterday also, all the speed questions, so Doppler's effect, any question, try to find the calculation between the frequency and the speed of sound. Some relation will be there. Always. It work every time. 13 into 110. Because this is 3 into 110. No? Some logic already we are getting off. Cool. At the instant when they are moving, when they are 10 meters apart, the stationary man is equidistant from them. The frequency of beats in hertz heard by the stationary man. Now, one thing we know. So, basically, there is one small technical issue. Let me just get it to sort it out. So this is the diagram again. It's the same diagram as before, but I flipped it just to make you understand that even if you flip it, doesn't matter. Okay. Up or down is same because it's a beats question. Now, one thing I want you to understand. The speed here is 2 meters per second. Right? The speed here is 2 meters per second. And the speed here is 1 meter per second. So along the direction, what do we know about beats? Beats will only work when velocity of source or observer, source or VS, are along line of line joining them. Remember this logic, only the speeds will be along the line joining them. The other speeds will are immaterial. Like if you are standing in the middle, if you're standing and the whistle is moving around in circle with you as the center, what is the frequency you will hear? It will be equal to the frequency of the whistle. Here, if this is giving a frequency of f naught, f s source, then f observed will be equal to fs, because the distance between them is not changing. The only distance between them changes, that is when the beats will, when the frequency will vary. Getting it? When the relative distance, displacement between both of them is changing, that is when Doppler's effect will come into picture. That is what I wanted to understand. So both of them along the line of AO and along the line of OB, we will find out. Now if you observe this this one is going away, right? Same angle theta. This is going away and this is coming towards. A is coming towards, which means frequency will increase. Implies f dash will be greater than f naught. And B is away. Implies f double dash will be less than f naught. And beats will be how much? F dash minus f double dash. Simple. Just substitute values we'll get. Now, what is f dash? It will be f naught into. So again, the source is moving. If the source is moving, we have to use the denominator. Getting it? If it is moving towards this observer, you will have to put minus. If it is moving away from the observer, you have to put plus because the frequency will decrease by logic. So it will be, we'll be right v by v plus va. We'll call this va into cos theta, right? The component of this along this will be va cos theta. If this is va, this will be va cos theta. And this is vb, this will be vb cos theta. Getting it? And f double dash will be, so since it's moving towards, we'll have to root minus va. And for double dash, it's moving away, so we'll put plus va. V by v plus vb, sorry. V into cos theta. Getting it? This is how we'll do it. And again, I tell you, for here we can use approximation. Since the velocity of the sound is very high and velocity of the observer is very less, of the source is very little, I can directly write these both as f naught into v plus va cos theta. Getting my point? By v. So denominator, numerator, I'm just shuffling. Niche minus will become upper plus. Upper plus, minus will become niche plus. That logic I'll use. And this will become f naught into v minus vb cos theta by v. This is a simpler method of solving. You can also take v common and you can cancel both of them and you can get the answer. So that is also one method, or this is also a simpler way of explaining it. So whatever is minus in the denominator will come to the positive in the numerator and vice versa. Getting it? So now beats will be how much? F naught by v into v plus va cos theta minus v minus vb cos theta. From this directly I'll get f naught by v into va plus vb into cos theta. Just substitute the values now, we'll get the answer. Got it? So what is frequency 1430? If it's in denominator, calculation is easy. How? Numerator is easy, no? 330. Directly, that's why I could add va plus vb here, man. If it is in denominator, how will I subtract? Yogeshwar, come on. So va is 2 and vb is 1 into cos theta. What is the value of cos theta here? Directly, this is right angle triangle. Cos theta is adjacent by hypotenuse. This is 5, this is 12. So how much will this be? It's a right angle triangle. This will be root 5 square plus 12 square, which is equal to 13. Okay, 5 square is 25, 12 square is 144. Add them, it's 169. Square root of 169 is 13. This is a very standard number you can remember also in calculation. So directly cos theta will be how much? Cos theta will be adjacent, which is 5, by hypotenuse, which is 13. Substitute these values. 1430 by 330 into 3 into 5 by 13. Now you get it, no? This is 13 elevens are, yes, Pythagoras triplet. 13 elevens are, 1 tens are 1430. And 110 into 3 is 330. 330, 330 have gone, directly you will get the answer as 5. This is the magic of using right way of calculating. Like we discussed here, 1430 is 13 into 11. I'll do that also here. This 1430 is 13 into 110 into 3 by 330, which is 110 into 3 into 13 into 5. That's all. So the answer is just one single 5. Since it's an integer question, since it's not integer, it's a numerical value question, you have to put a dot point 0. I think even 5 will do. Okay. Next. A ring and a disc are initially at rest, side by side, at the top of an inclined plane. The ring and a disc are initially at rest, on side by side on the top of an inclined plane, like this. Ring or disc. They start to roll without slipping at the same instant, the time, instead of time. They are starting together. Will the accelerations of both of them be same? Tell me. Both of them are starting rolling. They are rolling without slipping from the top of the inclined plane. Will the acceleration be same for both of them? Yes, Yogeshwar, tell me. I'll give you 1 minute to think about it. This is a very important point you have to understand. Will it be same? Guys, answer. Good. M24, very good. They won't be same because there will be extra kinetic energy. Now, I'll tell you one method of understanding it. I hope you guys understand this. Yes, good, Ishwar. Yes, sir, Yogeshwar. What, man? Ray. Yogeshwar. Let me tell you. Always think in no by mistake. He changes with moment of inertia. Very good. Sim24, you are doing it right. But again, it is not also 100% correct, but you understood. I know you got it, but let me tell you. Change in potential energy, when it's falling down like this, the change in potential energy will be equal to the negative of change in kinetic energy. Or you can say minus delta U is equal to delta KE. Okay. Now, this delta KE will have both rotational and translational kinetic energy. Okay. Rotational plus translational. Now, that is the main point. So, from this only directly I can write off. Okay. So, MGH, both of them are falling same height. Okay. He's saying the inclined plane, height of the top of the inclined plane in meters. Okay. So, this, let me explain that the kinetic energy will be both rotational translation and the rotational kinetic energy will be different for both disk and ring. Because rotational moment of inertia is different for same mass, same radius. Ring will have mr square, disk will have mr square by 2. So, the rotational kinetic energy is different, matlab, the total kinetic energy, the speed will be different. Getting it? The speed will be different means they will have different acceleration. If it comes fastly, it will have more velocity. If it accelerates slowly, it will have less speed. That way you can understand. So we'll use not in this question, but we'll use it. So now let me solve it. You all know this acceleration can be written as g sine theta. This is what I'm saying. By there, I'll introduce new concept called the mass equivalent of rotation. Okay. M plus I by r square. This is only what I call as the mass equivalent of rotation. So everywhere the mass will be same, but the equivalent of rotation will increase. Mass equivalent of rotation. If you add this everywhere, you'll get the answer. So acceleration of disk will be g sine theta by mg sine theta by, sorry. M plus, what is I for a disk? Mr square by 2 into r square. So from this directly I'll get 2g sine theta by 3. Getting it? Acceleration of disk will be 2g sine theta by 3. Acceleration of ring will be mg sine theta by m plus mr square by r square. Now directly I'll get it as g sine theta by 2. So if you observe directly here only, we are getting they both have different accelerations. This A1 is, A of disk is 2g sine theta by 3 and A of ring is g sine theta by 2. A of disk, we'll call this A of ring. Okay. Now from this, now how do we calculate the time difference? Provided they are following a displace, this is the acceleration along the incline. Okay. And this is h. So how much will this become? I call this d. Sine theta is opposite by hypotenuse. From this I can get d will be h by sine theta. Okay. Why I am doing this by sine theta with into sine theta, there is they both will get cancelled now. Okay. Time taken will be root 2h by g, no? 2h by a. 2d by a. Basically, whatever distance is traveling by the acceleration. So for time of a disk will be how much? Root 2 into h by sine theta into g sine theta by 2. By 2 until numerator will go up. So from this directly I can write it as 4h by g sine square theta. Time of disk. And time of ring will be, oh, disk is 2g sine theta by 3, no? By 3. Directly I'll get the time to be 3. And time of ring will be root 2h by sine theta into 2 by g sine theta. So from this I'll get it as root 4h by g sine square theta. Getting it? So now the difference between both of them I'll have to calculate. Time of disk, time of ring is I, no? रिंग माइनस टाइम ऑफ डिस्क इज इक्वल टू जस्ट टेक एच बाई सी जी एच रूट एच बाई जी इन टू वन बाई साइन थीटा इज कॉमन एंड फ्रॉम हियर आई विल गेट रूट फोर इज टू माइनस वॉट आई एम गेटिंग. सो इट इज इक्वल टू टू माइनस रूट थ्री बाई रूट टेन इज गिवेन. नो वॉट इज गिवेन हियर इज इक्वल टू टू माइनस रूट थ्री बाई रूट टेन. सो दिस इज वन मेथड वी कैन गेट इट. सो वी आर ऑलरेडी गेटिंग दिस. वॉट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ साइन थीटा? साइन थीटा इज साइन सिक्सटी. नो साइन थीटा इज इक्वल टू साइन सिक्सटी विच इज इक्वल टू रूट थ्री बाई टू. आई सब्स्टिट्यूट दिस ऑल्सो हियर. फ्रॉम दिस वॉट आई गेट रूट ऑफ एच बाई टेन इंटू रूट थ्री बाई टू इज इक्वल टू वन बाई रूट टेन. दिस इज वॉट वी आर गेटिंग. अंडरस्टूड? सो रूट टेन एंड रूट टेन आर गॉन. इफ यू ऑब्जर्व रूट टेन आर रॉन्ग गॉन एंड यूल गेट एच इज इक्वल टू रूट थ्री बाई टू. सो इनिशियल वेलोसिटी इज जीरो, एस इज इक्वल टू हाफ ई टी स्क्वेयर. यू कैन यूज, या दैट इज वॉट आई डिड नो फ्रॉम दैट ओनली. एच बाई साइन थीटा इज इक्वल टू हाफ इंटू ए टी स्क्वेयर. फ्रॉम दिस ओनली आई गेट डिस्टेंस. सो फ्रॉम दिस ओनली आई गेट हाइट इज टू ए टू एस बाई ए विच इज वॉट आई यूज नो टू डी बाई ए. गेटिंग इट? आई यूज द सेम फॉर्मुला. फ्रॉम दैट विल गेट टाइम इज टू डी बाई ए. सो फ्रॉम दिस वॉट विल आई गेट? एच इज इक्वल टू थ्री बाई फोर विच इज 0.75 मीटर्स. गेटिंग इट? योगेश्वर यू गॉट द पॉइंट राइट. एस इज इक्वल टू हाफ ए टी स्क्वेयर. फ्रॉम दिस वॉट इज एस इन द इक्विवेलेंट क्वेश्चन? डी. एंड ए इज वॉट एवर ए इज देयर. फ्रॉम दिस ओनली आई गेट टाइम इज इक्वल टू रूट टू एस बाई ए विच इज वॉट आई यूज. गेटिंग इट? कूल, यू गॉट हाफ ए देयर बट इट्स द सेम थिंग. सो आंसर इज 0.75. 3/4 इज 0.75. गुड गुड जॉब. या पाइडा यू गॉट इट राइट. यस एग्जैक्टली. पंजाब बंद मैच दे विल मैन ऑफकोर्स. ऑलरेडी ओवर? ओके दट वॉज फास्ट. ओके स्प्रिंग ब्लॉक सिस्टम आई सॉ 11/3 बेसिकली. आफ्टर दैट आई डिडंट सी. आई थिंक दे गॉट ऑल आउट पंजाब आरसीबी. दे आर ओनली अगेंस्ट सनराइजर्स दे विल विन. अगेंस्ट अदर टीम्स आर नॉट परफॉर्मिंग एज यूजुअल. ओके so one more thing I want you guys to tell, I want you guys to know. Okay, I am discussing cricket. I'll also discuss football. I'll discuss movies and all. Why is? Because I know one thing for sure, that in the current generation, no matter how much teachers are strict about it, even I don't support you guys watching it like all in full match. I don't want you guys to watch. But what I want you to understand is that watching it is not a crime, but after watching, if you are still in that same mood, what I believe is, if your mind is fully properly refreshed with what you like doing, then automatically studies also will become more fun for those who don't like studying much. So what I want you guys to do is, if you want, see highlights of a match, but then once you see half an hour highlights, go back and study, then come back, take a break, see half an hour of the match, or see last 5 hours of a match, then go study for 1 hour, first 5 hours or something, watch whatever you like and then go study for the entire time, because cricket is too much waste of time. I watch cricket, I am a big fan of it also like you guys, and I know how tough it is to not watch it, especially in these kind of situations. Even now you want to watch it, so watching is not a problem. But what I want you guys to do is to reward yourself as watching the match. You do some hard work, study well, then reward yourself. Work hard for the entire day, from afternoon study for 5 hours 6 hours straight, 1:30 to 7:30 I want you guys to be studying through all problems, and after 7:30 I want you guys to, if you watch match, you can do it. That is what you should, that is how you should reward yourself. Okay, watching match should be fun. Okay, I know it is, but bring some meaning to it. That is what I want you guys to do. Because lot of you guys watch it, I know very few students. Like, that is the problem, no? A lot of you think those who are studious only will get IIT, which is not, bhai. I used to watch all cricket matches when I'm watching. Yeah, exactly. Sim24 is doing it bang on. The other matches, if you want, watch highlights. But your favorite team, okay, one day you can take a break. But for that, you have to work hard. Equal hard and equal play. All work and no play makes Jack a dull boy, okay? So I'm not telling you to just sit and work, study, study, study. But you have to have balance between both of them. Especially that will work in the long term also. You will not get tired of studying eventually. If you enjoy doing it, enjoy studying and do others also which you enjoy. Enjoy everything. Don't just, if you sit with studies only, you will eventually lose the enjoyment there, because if you do the same thing for so long, it will become very tough. That is the main issue I want you guys to tackle, and that is what I'm giving you suggestions for. Yes, like watching full match on finals, every other match watch highlights. And if your exams are done, you have nothing to do, it's a different story. But if you're preparing well, this is the best method, I'm telling you. You'll feel so good about it. I used to do that every time. I used to watch highlights every match. I used to study for 2 hours, 3 hours. Then the moment I'm done, I used to, that is what my strategy is, write a test. Write one exam, finish the exam, 3 hours ka practice of practice test. Evaluate yourself. If you're getting good marks, watch a match, take a break, 1 hour, 1.5 hour. You didn't do well, practice the problems you did wrong, and then take a break. That is the best way to really feel good about it. Even better, man, Ishwar, that is the best thing, okay? If you don't like cricket, it is the best. I have respect for you, those who don't watch cricket, because it is a very good thing, the right thing to do. Okay, yes, so now let's get back to this question. Spring block system is resting on a frictionless floor, as shown in the figure. The spring constant is 2 Newton per meter. Okay, and block mass is 2 Newton. Everywhere it is 2, man. This is going to be very easy to calculate. Just substitute values. So that is what. If the values are very complicated, do use equations. But if the values are small, just calculate them right away. This method you can use to optimize your time. It is around 2 seconds. What 2 seconds? Let's see. We'll solve it and we'll get the answer. Okay, so spring force, what is the time period of spring? 2 pi root k by m, no, 2 pi root m by k. So m and k are equal. This is the best part of it, which is 2 pi seconds. So directly this we can understand. Okay, time period of movement of this 2 kg block we got off. Ignore the mass of the spring. Initially, spring is in unstretched condition. Initially, it is in free state. Another block of 1 kg moving with 2 meters per second collides elastically with the first block. Elastic collision, which means after collision, this will go with some v1. And this will go with, okay, I'm taking v1 and v2 in opposite directions because I know less small lighter block will generally reverse direction. Heavier block will not change direction when it's hitting, but lighter block will reverse direction in elastic collision. That is what I used. The distance in meters between the two blocks when the spring returns to unstretched position. So what will happen? The spring will go forward and come back like this. By the time it comes back, this will go some particular distance. He's asking us to find that distance. Okay, so what is full time period? It is time period means for going forward and backward and going forward and backward to the same phase. Getting it? So this is one half, and this is one half. Total is full time. So from this directly we can say that time in which it block returns will be exactly half of it, half of time period, which is 2 pi by 2, pi seconds. Getting it? So the time taken is pi seconds. That is the first part. Now, what is the velocities? This is the first next thing we have to find. This is going at 2 meters per second, 1 kg block at rest. Finally, this will have v1 and this will have v2. This is 2 kg block and this is 1 kg block. We know momentum is same. What is the initial angular momentum, initial linear momentum? Initial p will be 2, I cap direction. Final momentum will be how much? V1 into 2, m1 v1. Plus m2 v2, which is 1 into plus what is the velocity? It's backward direction. No, I gave. So I'll write this. Getting it? So these both should be equal, which means 2 will be equal to 2 v1 minus v2. This is the first equation. And one more thing we know, coefficient of restitution equation, which is speed of separation by speed of approach. Speed of separation by speed of approach should be equal to 1. What is the speed of separation? This is going v1 this way, v2 this way, which means v1 plus v2 by speed of approach is 2 will be equal to 1. From this, we will get v1 plus v2 is equal to 2. This is the second equation. So equate both of them. V1 plus v2 is equal to 2, and 2v1 minus v2 is equal to 2. Add both of them, I will get 3v1 is equal to 4. V1 is equal to 4 by 3, and v2 is equal to 2 by 3. We got off. And time it returns is 2 pi seconds. So distance will be v2 into t, no? This block will go forward and come back, and this block after collision, 1 kg block, will go forward with speed of 2 by 3 meters per second. Getting it, which is v2. So how much distance will it travel? The distance traveled will be v2 into t. What is the t? T is half the total time, no? So directly I'll write it as 2 by 3 into time is pi seconds, which is 2 into 3.14 by 3, which is approximately 2.09 meter. That is the answer. Got it? This is around 2 meters. Very good, man. Correct. Time is not, time you got wrong. Okay. But distance you got right. So eventually you got, but one more thing, you have to write the up to how many decimals. We didn't discuss that. I didn't see the, based on the decimal places, you have to write this. If the decimal places are given as 3 decimal places, everywhere you have to write 5.05 and so on. Okay. So getting that question, so just observe this. Okay, so the question actually said you have to write it. If you observe carefully, this is very important point. Okay, so one thing is given here is that you have to write every value up to 2 decimal points. So every question you have to write answers up to 2 decimal points. That is the most important thing you have to understand, because that is where you will lose out. Okay, so this is the question. Let's see the next question. From this, I'll tell you exactly what you have to write. Three identical capacitors C1, C2 and C3 have capacitance 1 microfarad each, and they have uncharged initially. They are uncharged initially. But in C2, there is a dielectric. If you observe, there is a dielectric here. Once, initially S1 is closed, while S2 is kept open. So initially, C3 capacitor is getting charged. Okay, that is the first thing. It is getting charged up to whatever value. V0 is given as 8 volts. So we have to find C3 is equal to C into V. Capacitor charge is equal to CV. We can find out the value there. Now once S2 is kept open, now once C3 is fully charged, S1 is now open, which means charging is there only, and now S2 will be closed. So this charge will get distributed across all the three capacitors. The value of ER is given that C3 has 5 microfarad. So initially what is the charge on this? Charge will be equal to 8 CV, right? Q is CV. From this we can write 1 micro coulomb into 8 volts, which is equal to 1 microfarad into 8 volts, which is 8 micro coulombs. So initial charge is 8 micro coulombs, and finally he is saying the charge will be 5. So initially it is plus 8 and finally it is plus 5, which means plus 3 goes in this direction, plus 3 micro coulombs. So total charge flow will be equal to how much? 3 micro coulombs from the given question. Understood? Total charge flow is 3 micro coulombs. And he is saying that this is the final state of equality. So what is the potential difference? Potential difference will be equal to Q by C, no? It is Q by C. And what is C is proportional to epsilon. C is E naught A by D, no? So here I will give directly use ratios. Because epsilon A by D and all I won't write. I will write directly V is proportional to 1 by epsilon naught. So this way I will write off. What will I get? 5 by 1 microcoulomb plus, this is minus, no? Here from, let's take from here. From here to here, the charge increases plus 5 by 1 microcoulomb. And from here to here, the charge, the potential difference will be minus 3 by 1 microcoulomb into epsilon naught r. Getting it? Into ER. And this will be plus 3 microcoulomb to minus 3, no? So it will be minus 3 by 1 microcoulomb. So I can take minus 1 microcoulomb common everywhere, I cancel it, I will get 5 minus 3 by ER minus 3 is equal to 0. So directly I can write the equation 2 is equal to 3 by ER, or ER is equal to 3 by 2, which is equal to 1.50. Getting it? So the answer is 1.50 here, because you have to round it up to 2 decimals. You have to write up to 2 decimal values. Getting it? So that is what is given in the question paper. I didn't put that here in the questions, but I will put that. So the value is 1.50. Getting it? Now here, in the xy plane region, y is greater than 0. In the xy region, y is greater than 0. The magnetic field is B1 k cap. This is B1 in the outside direction. Getting it? It is in the outward direction. When y is less than 0, there is another uniform magnetic field B2 k cap. B2 is also outside only, k-cap direction. So it is B2 k-cap, up it is B1 k-cap. Cool, we got it. Initially speed V0 is given as 5 meters per second. So V0 is upward and B1 is outward. Getting it? B1 is outward, which means how will the particle move? It will move in a circle like this. And what will the radius be equal to? MVR is equal to QB, no? So R will be QB by MV. Getting it? QB by M into V. That is the value. Okay. So from this, this will move how much distance? Let's take directly, this will be 2R1. So wait, let me draw this diagram here. I have the drawn diagram here. This is B1, this is B2. This is 2R1, this is 2R2. Because see, here it will move in this direction because Q into V cross B, the moment it comes here, it will have this direction. And Q into V cross B will be inward now. Getting it? So how will this particle move? It will move like this now. Getting my point? Initial movement is V cross B. It is in clockwise, in the forward direction. And in the second case, you know the direction of velocity is just opposite. So it will move in the opposite direction. Got it? So it will go 2R1 in this direction, in the forward direction, and it will come back in 2R2. Now what is this given? B2 is 4B1, which means R1 will be QB. Q into B1 by M into V. Okay. So B2 is 4 times B1. Q into BV is equal to MV square by R. Man. One mistake. Velocity is equal to Q into B into R by M. So radius is MV by QB, which is what I wrote, no? I wrote QB by MV, yeah, okay, yeah, exactly. That is the formula here. Someone tell me if I'm solving it along. So when I'm solving it, there will be some little here and there, which is what you have to catch, okay. Radius 1 will be M. What is the mass of the, what is the velocity, which is pi, no? Pi M by QB1. And radius 2 will be how much? Pi M by Q into B2, which is also equal to 4B1. So from this I can say R1 by 4 is equal to R2. Getting it? R1 by 4 is equal to R2. So that I'll apply here. 2R1 minus 2R2, which is equal to 2R1 minus 2R1 by 4, which is nothing but 3R1 by 2 is the total displacement. Getting it? In one full circle. He is asking the time when the particle crosses the x-axis from below for the first time. Like is crossing the x-axis from below for the first time. At this instant, he is asking us. So, B2 is given as B1. The average speed of the particle in meters per second along this whole time interval t. So, this is the total distance. And he is telling the total time. T is the total time in which it crosses x-axis from below for the first time. So, in this time, he is asking us the average speed. We know the distance now. The distance is 3R1 by 2. Which is also equal to 3 by 2 into pi m by q b1. Okay, this is first equation. 3 by 2 pi m by q b1. Now, what is the time? For time, let me tell you. The total distance traveled will be how much? Pi r. Okay. So, what is the time? Time will be pi r by v, which is equal to pi into mv by q b v. If you observe carefully, time will always be equal to pi m by q b. Got it? So it will be independent of speed. That is what you understood this point. Time in semicircle is independent of speed. Getting it? This is the major thing you have to observe. This will be very useful. So T1 will be pi m by QB1 and T2 will be pi m by Q into 4B1. So directly we can write time will be 5 pi m by QB1, right? 4QB1. This is the time. Total time will be this. Got it? So total time is this and total distance is that. So what is average speed? Average velocity is displacement by time along positive x direction. So from this, what can I say? According to the given diagram, it is in the positive x direction, no? Like this. This is displacement. Value of displacement is this. Value of time is this. So V average will be T by 2 pi m by QB1. If you observe, this is like everything is getting cancelled. 5 by 4 into pi m by qb1, which is equal to 3 by 2 into 4 by 5, which is 1.20 meters per second. Got it? It's a simple calculation here. It is 1.2 meters per second. 1.20. Basically, you have to write up to 2 decimals. So, this is the right answer. Got it? It is a little lengthy, but if you understand the logic behind it, you will directly get it. That one way it is moving in circle, the other time it is moving in anti-clockwise. Got it? Okay. Next question. The sunlight of intensity 1.3 kilowatt per meter square is incident normally on a thin convex lens of focal length 20 centimeters. Okay. Ignore the energy loss of light due to the lens and assume that the lens aperture size is much smaller than its focal length. The average intensity of light in kilowatt per meter square at a distance 22 centimeters from the lens. 22 centimeters from the lens, you have to on the other side. So light is, there is a lens like this. This is the principal axis. Light rays which are falling like this will pass through focus and go like this. What is the focus? This distance is given as 20 centimeters. And this distance will extra, it will be 22 is the total, no? So this will be 2 centimeters. So one thing I want you to understand that this radius here, R2 and R1, let me call this R1 and R2. R1 by R2 will be equal to 20 by 2, D1 by D2 basically. If you call them D1 and D2, R1 by R2 will be equal to D1 by D2, which in this case is equal to 20 by 2, is 10. And what do we know? Intensity into the total energy will be same, right? Assuming he is giving that the lens aperture size is much smaller than focal length, and he's saying energy loss due to the lens will be neglected. If the energy loss is neglected, which means energy initial will be equal to energy final. And what is energy? Energy is intensity into area square. Area. Intensity is intensity is energy by area. So energy will be intensity into area. From this we can also say I1 into A1 will be equal to I2 into A2. And also know A is proportional. It's a circular thing, no? So A will be proportional to R square. So directly I can write I1 into R1 square will be equal to I2 into R2 square. So I2 will be equal to I1 into R1 by R2 whole square. All of these are just simple one-step methods. You will get the answers directly. So directly I2 will be equal to 1.3 into R1 by R2 is 10 already given, 10 square, which is 130.0 kilowatt per. So the answer is 130.00. Getting it? So this way you can directly analyze it in a smaller fashion. No need to even calculate how the light rays move and all. This light ray will pass through focus and then go to infinity like this. So eventually at 40s, at some other distance, the intensity will be same. What is the distance? That can also be a question. When this separation will be equal to the next operation. If both are equal, then intensity here will be equal to intensity there. So what will this distance be? 20 centimeters. Got it? That way also you can analyze. That can also be the question. You can give you the intensity and you can, he can ask you at what distance will that be there. That time you have to do, here we did square, no? That time we'll do D1 by D2 will be equal to I1 by I2 under root you will get. Something like this you will get. Ulta. Square and root. That way you can get the answer. Okay, next question. Two conducting cylinders of equal length but different radii are connected in series between two heat bathtubs. One temperature T1 is at 300 Kelvin and T2 is at 100 Kelvin. Okay, how will heat flow? Along this direction. That is the first inference we can do. Okay, as shown in the figure. The radius of the bigger cylinder is twice that of smaller one. The radius of the bigger cylinder is twice that of the smaller one, which means radius of the bigger cylinder, if you take it as 2r, will be understood. Radius of bigger cylinder is twice that of the smaller one. The thermal conductivities of the materials of the smaller and the larger cylinders are k1 and k2. K1, this is k2. If the temperature at the junction of the two cylinders is in steady state at 200 Kelvin, temperature is given as 200, k1 by k2. This is a very interesting question. Okay. Temperature of 1 and temperature of 2 and temperature in the between, in the interface. This is 300, this is 200, this is 100, which means this delta T1 will be equal to delta T2. Okay. So, I will explain a simple method. Delta T is like, we will use the current equivalence. Okay. Delta T is only potential difference is equal to I thermal. V is equal to IR, I will tell you. V is equal to IR, right? Same way here I will write delta T is equal to I thermal into resistance thermal. So this I will solve now. Delta T is equal to I thermal into resistance thermal is 1 by K into L by A. You know this, right? Thermal resistance is 1 by L by K. Now what do we know from the question? We know delta T is same. And we also know I thermal is same. Because same heat is flowing from one end to the other. You know, steady state means same heat is flowing from left to right. The same heat, which means I is same. They are in series. And thermal temperature difference is also same, which means the thermal potential difference is also same. So from this, we can also say that R thermal should be same. That is only the same. That is only the inference. So there is no big calculations here. R thermal should be same. What is R thermal? L 1 by K1 into A1 should be equal to L2 by K2 into A2. Samajh gaya? L1 and L2 are also given as same. Both are L's. So L is also same. But areas are different. So from this directly I will get K1 by K2. I will send L1 and L2 are same. So directly K1 by K2 will become, that's it exactly, will become how much? A2 by A1. Now we know A2 is proportional to R square. R2 square by R1 square. Square by. Very good. Good one, Yogeshwar. You got the hang of it now. So this is the right answer. You understood how, right? It's a simple method. Whenever you have these kind of ratio questions, no, whenever he's asking the ratio of twos, never solve the full problem. Always leave solution calculation till the end. Ratios especially. If anything else, big questions are differences and all are given, that time you can simplify. Differences are given, you can simplify, but ratios are given. No, don't solve till the last moment. Okay, there is 4.00. Got it. Yay! So we are done with the second half of it, which is all problems or numerical problems. We are done with numerical problems. Now we are left with two comprehensions. And that's it. After two comprehensions, we are done with this paper. So good job, guys. We are almost done. Good job, Yogeshwar. You are there till the end. So understand the tricks I have told, whatever I have told. And see the perspective in which I am going through. Okay, the perspective which I am solving through is a simpler method. So like you just said, angular momentum will be I omega or MVR. How do we choose? Based on what is given in the options. So that kind of perspective is what I want you guys to understand before going to the exam. Because formulas, so you'll remember many formulas, but understand which one should be used. Got it? Okay. In electromagnetic theory, the electric and magnetic phenomena are related to each other. Therefore, the dimensions of electric and magnetic quantities must be related to each other. The question below, E and B stands for dimensions of electric and magnetic fields. And E naught and mu naught stand for dimension of permittivity and this thing. Okay. So, L and T are dimensions of length and time. All questions are given, all quantities are given in SI units. You have to find which of the relation between this. Okay. What is force due to a charge? Force due to a field will be generally given by Q into E. Right. Force due to a field is Q into E, electric field. And force due to a magnetic field will be Q into V cross B, you know. Extra. So from this magnitude, I can write it as Q into V into B. So if you observe carefully, since dimensions are same, I can relate that both of them will have same dimensions. Dimensions of Q into E will be equal to dimensions of Q into V into B. So Q and Q will get cancelled. So directly I can write dimensions of E will be equal to dimensions of B into dimensions of V. What are the dimensions of V? V is meters per second. No? From this I will get L into T power minus 1. So E will be P L T power minus 1. If it's given separately, L will be there, T power minus 1 will be there, which is option C. Got it? It is a fairly straightforward question, this one. Dimensional analysis questions are very easy if you do it in the right method. Okay. What Chennai? Ishwar? What? Where is Chennai? What are you talking about, man? Okay. Okay, so now let's do the last one, epsilon naught mu naught relation. For this, there is a simple method. You know that velocity of sound, velocity of light will be equal to 1 by root mu naught c naught. Oh, C for Chennai, very oh, nice. Very interesting, very good. Yeah, nice. Very nice, man. In fact, so now this is the formula we have to use. You know this, no? That velocity of sound will be equal to 1 by root mu naught epsilon naught. That is how speed. Basically, refractive index also will be this only. Refractive index, if you want me to tell you, mu r will be equal to 1 by root. Refractive index will be equal to mu naught mu r into epsilon r. Relative permittivities and relative. You know this, no? Same logic here also we can. Okay. So you want to find mu naught and e naught, no relation. So I'll send this to the other side. I'll say mu naught epsilon naught root is equal to 1 by c, or mu naught epsilon naught is equal to 1 by c square. So directly from this I'll get mu naught is equal to 1 by epsilon naught c square. So whatever epsilon power is there, those are nullified. Okay, so dimensionally I can write mu naught will be equal to epsilon naught powers minus 1 into c square plus e power minus 2. What is c? L t power minus 1, no? Power minus 2. So I'll get epsilon naught power minus 1 into L power minus 2 into t power 2. L power minus 2 should be there, t power 2 should be there. D for Delhi, Yogeshwar, yes, the answer is Delhi, no? So from this the answer is Delhi. Correct. Perfetto. The answer is D. Cool. So this is a very simple question. Next. If the measurement errors, David Warner. Very nice. Yes, guys, that is also D for Domino Center. Okay. Pizza. I want to have pizza now. Yeah, okay. So this is one more thing. If the measurement errors in all independent quantities are known, let's solve this question, then we can discuss for some time. Okay. If the measurement errors in all independent quantities are known, then it is possible to determine the error in any independent quantity. This is done by using series expansion and truncating the expansion in the first power of error. Too much. Okay. Nothing is like this. I'll tell you simple method. For example, consider the relation z is x by y. The errors in x and y are given, z and delta x, delta y, delta z respectively. So from this z plus or minus delta z is equal to x plus or minus delta x by y plus or minus delta y, which is x by y into 1 plus minus delta x by 2 into 1 plus minus delta y by y whole power minus 1, which is just what he did. It's just basic mathematics he did. He took x common in numerator, y common in denominator and multiplied everything. In series expansion, 1 plus or minus delta y by y power minus 1, the first power of delta y is 1 minus plus delta. Exactly. So this is what I keep telling. For plus or minus, if you go power minus 1, if you invert it, it will become 1 minus plus. This is what I keep telling, no? 1 plus delta x, provided delta x is very small. Limit delta x tends to 0 will be approximately equal to 1 minus delta x. Exactly ulta. So plus minus will become minus plus. Yeah, it is binomial formula only. Binomial expansion. That's all. Nothing else. Okay. So, this is given. So from this directly we'll get delta z is equal to z into delta x by x plus delta y by y. In the above derivation, the assumption he's making is delta x by x is much less than 1. That is what I did. Limit delta x tends to 0 is the same thing. Therefore, the higher powers of these quantities are neglected. That is all. Exactly. Yogeshwar, you got this one right. Yogeshwar is good at maths, no? Physics, you have to improve. Okay, it's okay, relax. I'll tell you something today only before going forward. Now consider ratio R is 1 minus A by 1 plus A. We determined by a measure of a dimensional quantity A, given the error is much smaller than A, delta A by A is much less than 1, then what is the del error in determining this? Okay, so delta R by R will be equal to delta numerator by numerator plus delta denominator by denominator. This is what I'll do. So delta R by 1 minus A into 1 plus A is equal to delta A by 1 minus delta 1 minus A plus delta A by 1 plus A. Getting it? This is how we should solve it. So from this, what will I get? Oh, I left extra place also. Let me solve this again. What is given? Delta R is equal to 1 minus A by 1 plus A. Okay. So delta R by R from the given equation only will be delta numerator by numerator plus delta denominator by denominator. This is what I'll do. Delta R by 1 plus A by 1 minus A is equal to The error in this will be delta A by 1 minus A plus delta A by 1 plus A. Doing both, I will get delta A into 1 plus A plus delta A into 1 minus A by 1 minus A into 1 plus A. Simple, no? Is delta R into 1 plus A by 1 minus A. So 1 minus A, I am getting cancelled both the cases. If you observe, that is the main thing you have to understand. 1 minus A is getting cancelled. So delta R will be how much now? Delta R into 1 plus A is equal to delta A plus A delta A. Delta A plus A delta A plus delta A minus A delta A get cancelled. So delta R into 1 by 1 plus A is also remaining. Delta R will be now how much? 2 delta A. Delta A by 1 plus A. Which is what option? Option Bangalore, Bombay, IIT Bombay. Yes, correct. Perfect. Now for the next, I think this is the last question. Yes, this is the last question. Yes, this is the last question. I have a small surprise in the end. For special, today's special. In an experiment, the initial number of radioactive nuclei is 3000. Okay. It is found that the 1000 plus or minus 40 nuclei decayed in the first second. But delta x is much less than 1. Ln 1 plus x is equal to x up to the first power of x. Exactly. The error in delta lambda in the determination of the decay constant lambda. Okay. So what can we say about this? For any given instant, the number of molecules final will be equal to n naught into e power minus lambda t. This is the one formula. I won't even use this ln 1 plus x and all. Okay. This is the formula we'll use. So for given value of lambda t to be much smaller, for much smaller this thing, so I can also write n final will be equal to n naught into 1 minus lambda t. This is the method I can use directly. So from this, n final by n naught is equal to 1 minus lambda t. So lambda I have to find, no? Lambda t will be equal to 1 minus n final by n naught. Okay. So measurement of time is perfect, 1 second. So I can directly write delta lambda by lambda into t will be equal to delta measurement of n final by n naught. N final by n. So from this, what can I get? Delta lambda by delta lambda by lambda into t will be equal to, what is total change, error in this 40, but what is the final value of n here? When out of 3000, 1000 have been decayed, no? Which means n final will be equal to n naught, n will be equal to 2000. You're getting it? So from this, we'll get 40 by 2000 is the error in measuring this. Okay, delta lambda by lambda will be equal to 40 by 2000. Are you getting the point? So error in measuring lambda will be 40 by 2000, which is 1 by 50, or you can also write it as 0.0. So the correct option here is Chennai. Got it? So at that instant, n0 is 2000. No, n0 at that instant, at a given instant, this is how it will be. So from this, we can get the answer to be 0.0, which is Chennai. So this is the end of 2018 paper 1. Tomorrow we will have paper 2, guys. Okay, this is paper 1. Tomorrow we will be discussing paper 2 of 2018. So this is where the main latest questions are there, the tricky parts which we generally discuss, which is more recent. We'll do paper 2 of this thing tomorrow, and 2019 paper 1 and paper 2 I'll be discussing in the next 2 days. Got it? We are almost at the end of it. And so don't forget to log in tomorrow also at the same time. On weekends, I'll do it a little early because everyone will be busy in the night on weekdays. I think you have to give you some break. But on weekdays, I'll give you at 10 o'clock in the night, which is when you guys are really being active, okay, from what I see. So any doubts about anything you want, you can ask me right now. Okay. Today's brain booster, exactly. Day after tomorrow at 4 p.m. Exactly. That is what I'll do. I know Sunrisers match also, no? Okay. So today's brain boosters I want you to understand is, you only tell me what you observed in today's classes, especially some special things. One thing is read the instructions. Okay. Read the instructions. Main thing. Don't forget, just don't get lost in writing the exam. You have to read the instructions. Keep your brain cool. Keep your brain cool. This is the next thing I want you to understand. You have to keep your brain cool. Only then you will get the answers. And next thing is read the options completely. Yes, last sum is Maclaurin series. I don't know the name of that, but that is Maclaurin series. Yeah, I'm telling you, Yogeshwar, your maths is good, man. You have to work on physics only. Physics tricks you have to understand. Okay. So these are the some things. And one more thing, ratios. Ratios may never calculate fully. Yes, good one, SM. SYM, very good. Good one, SYM. Great job. What it is 1 by 1 plus x can be written as 1 minus x. Okay, forget the plus minus thing. This is the general thing I want you to understand. Limit x tends to 0. So this will be very useful in calculating speeds of, like Usain Bolt did 100 meters per second in 9.5 seconds. Okay, this is approximately 10. No, 9.5 is close to 10. So if you ask what is V average, you can calculate 100 by 10 into 1 minus 0.5 by 10. So this will come out to be 100 by 10 into 1 plus 0.5 by 10. 10 by 10, 10. So you'll get 10.5 as the answer. Simple, direct, tuck. No need to even calculate 10, 100 divided by 9.5. 9.5 ones are 10s are 10 and all. You need not even do all those. This method will be very useful for simplification of problems. Getting it? So that is one very important thing I want you guys to understand. Simplification problems in calculations, this is the best method. Especially ratios also, this will be very useful. Okay. So anything else we observed today? Great job, guys. I'm very happy with how you guys are continuously, the number of students are increasing. So one more name with me, but hey, no sad names here. Okay. No sad names. We want happiness right now. This is what I want you guys. You guys have a lot of positivity. Oh man, RIP. Seriously. Dean Jones died, no? Yeah, even SP Balasubramanian is very seriously ill and Dean Jones expired. It's a very sad thing. Yeah. So RIP Dean Jones. I'll put that tomorrow. I'll just write it today. Great player, man. Okay. But today it is dominated by one guy, which is KL Rahul. SPB also is serious right now. Okay. Let's do that for later. SPB also is in serious. That's what I heard today. Yeah, qualitative analysis of physics. It is qualitative analysis of physics for competitive exams. We are not actually learning physics in what you are doing for the exams right now. If you understand it this way, it will become very easy to analyze physics. Okay. Don't take physics into deep. Don't start dreaming physics. Okay. We are not solving here to dream about physics. That is my approach and I would like to give it to you. It will be very effective. That is one very important point. I will note this down. I used to tell this to guys, qualitative analysis of physics for competitive exams. I stopped using this word actually. Very good. Competitive exams. So this is what we are doing. Okay. This is what we are doing. It is like you want to know enough physics to solve problems. You're not in this to dream physics. Okay, let's not go too technical into physics, because too much technical, if you go too much technical, you will start losing what is real, what is it useful for your solving problems, what is not useful. So you have to analyze it in a more mathematical way. That is what I want you guys to understand physics. And don't give me that if someone is good at maths and not good at physics, it is not a reason. No? People say they are good at physics but not good at maths. That is also not ideal. Okay. The ideal thing is you should be, if you are good in physics, you will be good in maths. If you are good in maths, you will be good in physics. Chemistry also, numerical chemistry will be same thing. If you are good at physics and maths, you should be good at numerical chemistry. Don't tell me chemistry is problem. केमिस्ट्री में द ओनली प्रॉब्लम विद दोज हु आर गुड एट कैलकुलेशंस इज ऑर्गेनिक इनऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री. ऑर्गेनिक ऑल्सो हैव लॉट्स ऑफ लॉजिक्स. वॉट आई एम टेलिंग इज या हैज द कॉलेज इफ यू वॉन्ट टू बिकम एन इंजीनियर योर इफ यू सो बेस्ड ऑन दिस आई कैन गिव यू एनालिसिस ऑल्सो. योगेश्वर आई थिंक यू विल बिकम ए गुड इंजीनियर. ओके बिकॉज यू आर डूइंग मैथ्स वेल बट यू आर नॉट टेलिंग फिजिक्स एप्लीकेशन प्रॉपरली. इंजीनियरिंग रिक्वायर्स लॉट ऑफ मैथ्स एंड साइंसेस रिक्वायर लॉट ऑफ फिजिक्स. And JEE exam, if you crack it, you can do both sciences and engineering. Both of them are possible. So it's not like only if you do good in maths, you will be doing, you have to go to IIT and all. Sciences are extremely good in IIT. Okay, I used to have a lot of friends who are very good. Like they used to kill it, not maths. They used to have a lot of theoretical part also. So don't think IIT is only for engineering. It is an engineering college which has awesome sciences. IISc and all also there, awesome colleges for science. So this is what for JEE majorly engineering students, this is what you need to understand about physics. Don't think physics is about understanding full physics, only then you can solve problems. Yogeshwar, especially you. Okay. Don't think physics means only logics, formulas you have to remember. To simply analyze physics in a practical way, you can imagine it. As long as imagination you can do, and then apply more maths. That way those who are good at maths can do physics. In fact, I personally learned mathematics by solving Iridov. I used to do Iridov and I used to learn mathematics from that. Iridov is a physics book. So that is how they are linked. Understood. So I think, so that is about today. Brain, that is the brain funda for today. Tomorrow I'll tell you more brain funda. Okay. I'll link it towards the exam also from tomorrow. Like we did a lot of them today also. I'll give some fundas tomorrow. I'll make a special slide for that. But today is about KL Rahul, man. What innings, like 132 runs of 69 balls. Strike rate of 191.9. Nice, no? How means 69 twos are 138. Less than that, ante 6 is little less than 6.9. 6.9 is 1 by 10. That way it is 190. 6.9 se thoda kam hai. Thoda zyada hai. 131.1 is 9 into 1.9. 1.9, that way I got 191. Perfectly correct. Check it in the calculation. That is my human calculator point of the day. But wonderful innings. Really, especially the last 2 hours, they scored 50 runs. It was great. Anything you want to say, you can tell. So this is what I will tell you about it. Last 2 hours, they scored 49 runs. So watch the highlights today of the match. Crazy. Watch the highlights. Don't watch the match. So that is about it, guys. Great job. It's been awesome interacting with you guys. So keep up this and from next week, any topic you want me to explain. Yeah, I'm up to date in boys, man. It is second season. I'm very disappointed. Especially second season. Kya, there's nowhere they're going. They introduced another strong female. But then that is, I thought she was the main villain in second season. At least she could have killed that fellow. Or that fellow would have some violence. Something should happen. It's happening. You need violence, man. That is how good series work. And you need to have crisp storyline. Storyline is going nowhere. No one is getting killed. No violence, nothing. Game of Thrones is killer, okay? Don't watch it now. After you go to college. That is the best time. Don't watch Game of Thrones. Trust me. Watch it after that. And boys also, don't watch it. It's useless. Boys, I didn't like. Best World is one. On the other hand, is one I like. Dark is also very good. But all of this, after the exam. Yes. Good job, guys. You've been there all around. Yeah, but let's not have that right now, okay? All of you guys who are giving JEE Advance, no movies or things right now. Food, cricket, because it is so exciting for you guys who follow cricket. I know everyone watches cricket. That is why I'm telling you, watch highlights. Otherwise, not right now. Just watch it for some time, okay? TV series work differently. TV series, if you start watching, you will not sleep. Your phone in the night inside your dupatta, you start watching it inside your phone is sleeping, you're watching. That is wrong. Okay, that is very dangerous. That is where I want you not to go. If you want to watch cricket, it is fine because it is live. Okay, you don't know what is happening, or if you watch it, it's too much time waste. You can watch highlights because you like to follow it. You like to see numbers, you like to see your batsman play. It is just a small time, it won't happen throughout the day. A TV series, if you start watching, there is no end to it. No, there are five seasons. Unko. Each episode, each season, 1 hour, 1 hour, 1 hour, 1 hour. Crickbuzz is perfect. Keep following Crickbuzz. But Again, what my method is, my method which I told you as a trick, is study for 3 hours without any avocation, take a break, watch 1 hour based on the test. Okay, this is one thing. I'll write it tomorrow. I'll write it today also. What you have to do is, this is especially for 2020 guys or 2021 guys also, this is the best way to prepare if you ask me. This is the way I prepared. I used to play every day for 1 hour in the evening. I used to meditate. I used to watch every cricket match, but I got a 385 rank because of this method. This method is extremely good. One thing is, write a 3 hour test. I keep telling this to everyone. I keep telling this again. I can't mention how important this is. This is step one. Step two is check answers, or ask your mother or parents to check answers based on that, so that you can be more truthful. Sometimes what you'll do is you'll put 1-2 answers. If you know it, you will put it here and there. that is not any whiskey or wine, it's water. It's acting. Okay, they don't drink in movies. Okay, the statutory here. Thinking. Yes. Here's to that. Okay. So now write a 3 hour test to check the answers. Don't forget, check the answers. Then if you are happy with the performance, play or watch cricket. If you are not happy, you're sad with your performance, practice all tests. Practice mistakes, then go play. So this loop you should maintain, okay? This loop, if you maintain, you will not get tired of studying, you will not get tired of enjoying, it will become so enjoyable for you guys. So this I'll also mention in the special class everywhere. Don't forget, you have to do this, okay? Every day, especially Sim24, Yogeshwar Paida, you're almost done with your college, no? You are writing 2020 exam. When are you writing the exam, Yogeshwar? But Sim24, you should follow this, okay? I know you should do it. Sim24, Ishwar, both you guys should be doing this, okay? And everyone who is watching this video till the end, if you have the patience to do this much, you can definitely write a 3-hour test. This is main. Why I am telling this is because 3-hour test of all three subjects. This is basically an exam simulation. Only thing is exam simulation without pressure. If you are writing 27th, only first day, okay, yaar, all the best. So if you are writing the exam at home, you won't have the pressure, okay. And you write, the main issue with you guys is, you guys write exams only in the college, okay. So ekdam, you see the environment, you get used to that environment, ki every time exam, you'll have that environment, you'll get tensed. But if you practice exam writing at home, it's like net practice. Writing exams at home is a net practice for exams. The moment you write so many exams at home, even outside exam will become like home exam for you. Everything will become like home exam and you'll be very cool. The moment you are cool, like what I said, keep your brain cool. That will happen with doing this. Understood? So do that and you'll and it is going to work brilliant. Okay. So thank you guys for watching this. And those who want to use the Unacademy Plus subscription, use the code NSS1 and avail 10% discount. Okay. Great job. We'll keep improving as it goes, okay? So, I'm pretty sure, I'm very happy with the way you guys are reacting. I hope it's getting better and better as we go. I'll keep adding new stuff as we go around, so it will become more awesome, more chill and more cool, okay? So, once the theory classes start, I'll put one Avenger every day. That's what I'm planning. One Avenger or one DC guy every day. So, let's see. I'll keep on improving. Thanks a lot for your replies and the way you are talking on the chat. It's very nice. Like, I feel like I'm talking to you guys. But if you want to continue, use this NSS1 code. And if you, especially you three guys, those who are, yeah, the glass board, I'm still working on it, man. The live with glass board is where I'm having a problem. So currently I'm doing this, especially for this Fortnite program. I'm going to do it on this. And initial classes also I made PPTs, which are fun to do. But the problem here is PPTs are more efficient to teach. Okay. Glassboard is more efficient to make small videos, which is why I am still not working with that. I'll see if I can get the technical aspect right. There is some inverting issues in live classes. तो लाइव क्लासेस में ग्लासबोर्ड के लिए इट इज अ लिटिल प्रॉब्लमैटिक राइट नाउ, बट आई विल वर्क ऑन इट. ओके, डोंट वरी, वी विल डेफिनेटली फाइंड अ वे. बट फॉर दिस फोर्टनाइट प्रोग्राम, दिस इज द फर्स्ट प्रोग्राम आई एम लॉन्चिंग ऑन अनअकैडमी, एंड आई'ड लाइक टू डू इट द वे दे अनअकैडमी वांट्स मी टू डू इट, व्हिच इज बाय पीपीटी. दैट इज व्हाई वी मेड अ पीपीटी, ऑसम पीपीटी, एंड यूज द कोड NSS1 टू अवेल एक्स्ट्रा 10% डिस्काउंट. ऑल यू गाइस शेयर दिस एवरीवेयर. ओके, आई वॉन्ट यू गाइस टू शेयर दिस ऑन योर वेबसाइट्स लाइक यूट्यूब और फेसबुक और एनी वेयर. शेयर दिस ऑन फेसबुक एंड इंस्टाग्राम, वॉट एवर यू गाइस आर यूजिंग. इंस्टाग्राम में शेयरिंग आई नो इज अ लिटिल टफ, बट इफ यू गाइस आर स्मार्ट इनफ यू कैन फिगर आउट अ वे. आई एम इंस्टाग्राम, आई एम इन इंस्टाग्राम, आई स्टिल आई एम नॉट गुड एट इंस्टाग्राम, सो उतना नहीं करता हूँ इंस्टाग्राम पे. बट ऑन यूट्यूब आई कैन, आई नो इट इज वेरी इजी टू शेयर. आई वॉन्ट यू गाइस टू शेयर इट एंड मेक इट वायरल, बिकॉज दीज ट्रिक्स, स्पेशली द लास्ट टू पेजेस वी डिड, दे आर गोल्डन वर्ड्स. ओके, दीज आर नॉट अवेलेबल एनी वेयर इन द एंटायर कंट्री. दिस आई एम टेलिंग यू फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम. ओके, इट्स अ न्यू मेथड विच आई फील इज परफेक्ट फॉर, विच इज आई बिलीव इज करेक्ट. ओके, स्पेशली विद द वे हाउ यू गाइज हैव योर माइंड, हाउ योर माइंड्स वर्क. बिकॉज आई नो इट इज डिस्ट्रैक्शंस आर एवरीवेयर, स्पेशली इन दिस जनरेशन. अब तुम ऐसे नहीं बैठ सकते हो कि यार, इट्स नॉट ओल्ड टेक्निक एनी मोर. टीचिंग और स्टडिंग इज नॉट, इट्स नॉट लाइक 2000, 2000s एनी मोर. विद द एडवेंट ऑफ सेल फोन्स एंड द वे इट इज बूम्ड एवरीवेयर, इंटरनेट एवरीवेयर, 4G, आई नो इट इज टफ टू होल्ड योर माइंड. सो दैट इज वाई आई एम टेलिंग, ब्रेक इट लूज फॉर सम टाइम एंड देन होल्ड इट. डोंट कीप होल्डिंग इट, इट विल बस्ट सम डे. सो दैट इज ऑल. यूज द कोड NSS1 टू अवेल 10% डिस्काउंट एंड हिट द बेल आइकॉन फॉर नेक्स्ट नोटिफिकेशन. लेट्स सी यू टुमारो एट 10 o'clock, guys, 10 PM. Yes, go Sunrisers, rise up to the challenge. Okay. So, until next class, adios, guys. See you. End of stream.